was able and willing to give a little blood on that bridge in Selma for the right to vote.
She said, "I'm awfully sorry. This is for City Hall employees only." And I said, "You have a big sign out on the street here. It says City Hall Cafeteria. The public is welcome." She said, "We don't mean it." I said, "Well, we'll stand here until you do."
We came into this store and sat in at the lunch counter, which is not customary. And at a human price and sacrifice, we changed the course of not only what you do in Greensboro, but the course of history relative to civil rights in this country.
He dreams of the day when black children and white children will play together, when Jewish children and Christian children will play together. Everything was together, together, together.
I thought he was talking just to me. Yet I was in a sea of several hundred thousand people. Even to this day, some 50 years later, I can transport myself back in my memory to that time. And that is inspirational, certainly in times when we're trying to figure out how do we make the American dream real, not just for some folks, but for everybody.
You happen to grow up in the 1960s.
What is the legacy that you want to leave for my generation?
What do you want my generation to know and understand?
You have to ask yourself, what is it I can do to push the needle forward?
Be inspired to do some of the same things or even bigger and better things.
And if we're going to create a world community at peace with itself, the young must lead the way.